In this slide, you see a simple linear equation y is equal to mx plus c. You may all recollect, you have learnt in analytical geometry y is equal to mx plus c, where c is the y-intercept and m is the slope, which is dy by dx. What it means to say is that y varies as x varies, and that is contributed by the slope and also a y-intercept. So this is the equation of a straight line which you have studied in linear regression. Precisely, this is the method which you are going to adopt in finding out the regression coefficient. But more importantly, we will understand little more how to arrive at the best fit line, and that is by a method called method of least square, and that is what we are going to learn. Now we will take a simple linear regression and then establish relationship between two variables, y and x, where y is the dependent variable and x is the independent variable, and we will establish the regression coefficient or arrive at the regression coefficient by certain calculation methodologies, and the method that is adapted is called the method of least square. Okay, and this is what is expressed. So the linear regression equation is y is equal to mx plus c, where m is the slope and y is the intercept on the y-axis. And there are other formulas also. These are all the things which I already learnt in analytical geometry. So we will just take it up further to understand how statistically we can use this relationship. Now, once you know that linear equations y is equal to a plus bx or y is equal to mx plus c, the same form is written in a different parameters here. So what happens is that they fall into two equations, and they are, once you solve these two equations, they are simultaneous equations, then you will be in a position to get the value of a and b. You all know in mathematics, simultaneous equation, if for two variables, if two equations are there, you can arrive at the solution. And in statistically, to evaluate or understand or arrive at the regression coefficient, we need to build a table. And the table is built up with the help of these data. X and y are the data, and x bar and y bar are the mean of the data, and this is x square and this is x bar square. So once you are able to establish all these things by way of a table, because x and y is available, x bar and y bar can be calculated, and we will be in a position to arrive at various parameters a and b. There are many methods you can use it. The regression coefficient can be computed in different ways. Deviation taken from the mean value, deviation taken from the assumed mean value, all these things you can do it. In terms of correlation coefficient also you can calculate. Now let us take an example and then see how you can arrive at the regression coefficient. Let us now understand the method of least square. This is typically the data points with the, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. And probably if you draw a trend line, it looks like this. Now these are all the vertical distance from the trend line to the actual data points. The objective of method of least square is to find an imaginary line that will give you a result in such a way that d1 square plus d2 square plus 3t square and d4 square is minimum. By this I mean that some of the squares of d1, d2, d3 and d4 will be minimum. Okay, and no other line can be as best or as better as this, and that is what is the principle of method of least square. Now we will take a couple of examples. Following table will provide the expenditure on advertisement and sales revenue for the past 5 years. Now we will calculate the regression coefficient, which is basically the slope of the line and also the y-intercept. Okay, these are all the data, the advertisement expenses in lakhs and revenue, and these are all the years. Okay, now we already said that we can build a table. If you look back, all you need is x square and xy and then summation of that, right? And this is what all the elements that you require to put it into the formulae to arrive at the regression coefficient. So the regression coefficient b or the slope is arrived by this formula. Once you substitute these values, you will get that. And again, a is the y-intercept, and that is given by this formula. And if you calculate, and this is what you get it. The slope is 0.13 and the y-intercept is 0.049. Now on that graph will typically look like this. Okay, this is the graph, or this is the best fit line for the data that you saw in the previous slide. So this is how you arrive at the method of least square. Now, if you actually plot those data points and the vertical distances are measured and squared them up, you will find for this slope and for this y-intercept, you will get the minimum value. Now, having arrived at the regression coefficient b and also the y-intercept, you will be in a position to predict, given certain value of x, what will be the value of y. We are shown here an example. If you spend 25 lakhs, which is x, okay, in the year 2020, you can expect a revenue of 2.7 crores, and that is what you can arrive at. So the regression coefficient will help you to calculate or predict for the future. We look at this example. This is motor winder and rejects. The proprietor of an agricultural motor company wishes to minimize the rejects in motor windings and wish to decide how many weeks of experience will be optimal. Okay, if he plans to have less than 25 rejects to engage his employee in motor winding. Let us now understand this example, and the data is provided in the table as shown. So this is the different winders and their experiences and how much rejection they cost. With 1 week of experience, there are 32 rejects. With 2 weeks of experience, there are 26 rejects. With 9 weeks of rejects, it will be 20. Like that, it goes on. Obviously, you will find that as the experience become more and more, you will find the reject rate is reducing also. Okay, and these are all the other two elements that you are required to calculate using the table. Okay, now you will find that when you calculate this one, you will find the regression coefficient as -1.29 and the y-intercept as 34.3. So this is typically a negative correlation, or the regression coefficient is negative. So as the experiences increases, you will find the rejection rate comes down, and that is what is very logical also. Okay, it's a negative correlation. For 3 weeks, if you wanted to calculate, so you should be hovering somewhere around that. The rejection rate will be 30, and for 7 weeks, its experience in winding, the rejection rate reduces to 25. So obviously his target is to ensure the rejection rate should be less than 25, and therefore you should deploy people who have got at least 7 weeks of experience in winding. So this is how you understand regression analysis, especially a simple linear regression, how you can use method of least square in calculating the regression coefficient and use it for projection and prediction.